Welcome back to the National Sports Centre here, Douglas in the Isle of Man, where we continue the Ireland Invitational Netball Games. We're halfway through the competition and, well, it's the Channel Islands Derby. We're going to go through the teams very shortly indeed, but it's Guernsey against Jersey in the match, which gets underway at 2 o'clock very shortly. We'll be going over to get our teams and live commentary.
Experience an island like no other. The Isle of Man, the extraordinary story. Book now.
Well, welcome to the Isle of Man and a very special event, the first of the Invitational Island Netball matches.
Playing against teams of this standard is something we don't get to do very often, being from an island community, and even watching some of the matches that's going to be coming up this week is going to be amazing experience.
The first time that we've been involved in anything of the scale as well, just the exposure for all our players is really good.
We've got 15 players with us and we have youth and experience. We're hoping to use everybody throughout the week.
We've had a look at some of the teams. We know the Isle of Man are 27th in the ranking at the moment, so know that they're going to be quite a tough team. Jersey and Guernsey have been a setter for quite a while now, and Orkney and Shetland as well are teams that we're looking to compete against.
Everyone says it's all fun and games, but you kind of want it to be serious. You want to go out with a few wins.
We're really lucky that we've got a really strong mix of players, that their combinations can be moved all around.
And for 5 days worth of netball, it's a lot to ask from them.
Absolutely. We know that those all 12 of the girls that are over with us are going to have to work their socks off. And for us, it's the first time we've done anything like this.
We know it's tournament netball and anything can happen. I'm going to have to earn every moment out there. But yeah, we'll be going for it for this week. We want to go out on top. Everyone has usually played everyone at some point and seen everyone at some point. That hasn't happened this time round, so there is a lot of unknown.
There's a much bigger picture at play here, and it's about not just representing your island, but representing netball at this competition and in the Island Games. And I think going forward, that's something that we all share, a common goal.
It's a great feeling playing for Orkney, and we've not really done anything outside of Scotland. And all we really have is our inter-county match against Shetland every year and the Scottish Cup that we enter.
I think for us, it's just seeing what we've done. Have we prepared in the way that we should prepare?
Yep,
or yep. Do we need to go back and reflect and see where we need to go for there?
We've hosted a few competitions like this now, but the nerves are still there and we still want to do well for a home crowd. So although we're experienced, we still get the same adrenaline. And that's what makes this competition quite exciting. It's nice to play new opponents and it's nice to play people that haven't played us before. So we're really looking forward to it. This has been all over social media. There's been a lot of excitement around it. And I think netball fans on the island are looking forward to this as well.
Probably just like to take a moment just to thank the Isle of Man Netball really for taking a leap of faith and backing the teams, backing the game and getting ourselves in a position where we can run something like this.
Welcome everyone, and this is the second game of day three, and as mentioned, it's that local island derby, Guernsey up against Jersey. So an exciting first game this morning, witnessed Orkney coming out victors against Ennismon, not without a fight though. Ennismon making some significant gains and improvements in their performance today. So that was a 65-40 scoreline in favour of Orkney. So teams coming onto court now as we welcome on Guernsey, and just to go through the team list for you. for Guernsey, goal shooter, Braho, goal attack, Yabsley, wing attack, Chamberlain, centre, Graham, wing defence, Haysom, goal defence, McCracken, and goalkeeper, Saunders. Coach for today's Guernsey game is Bridget Yabsley. So Bridget Yabsley taking over from Sally Kearns, and the bench, also Liv Cottrell, Abby Greening, Viv Kemney, Louise Pinchmain, Sophie Taylor. For Jersey, at goal shooter, Leah Griffin. Goal attack, Rosie Toner. Wing attack, Tallulah Norman. Centre, Antonia Chater. Wing defence, Jodie Blampede. Goal defence, Catherine Larish. And captain, Lauren Devine at keeper. As we see Guernsey get this game underway with Tilly Graham at centre. So, Jersey playing in the red and white strip today, as you see them in possession there with Blampede, and Guernsey in their green and black kit. So, Guernsey moving down as you look at the screen to your right, to your left, and Jersey to the right as Griffin secures that first goal. Moving towards post, and a great start from Jersey, converting off the Guernsey centre pass. So chance for Guernsey just to get a goal on the board, settle those early nerves. Abby McCracken, the captain at goal defence for Guernsey, supporting on the line. So Yabsley secures the first goal. Vicky Yabsley, solid performance from her at the goal attack position yesterday for Guernsey. Back in action straight away in this game. So Toner, great timed ball through to Griffin. Zola Saunders. Penalty call against Saunders gives Griffin a chance to put the ball away, and she does. Excellent start from Leah Griffin. Her real strength in the shooter position. Talked about Leah an awful lot, and the work there of Blampede, who secures and gets the ball back in the wing defence spot for Jersey. So pressure on Guernsey, particularly after the first phase of the centre pass. So what can be done is Jersey power on. Norman just a little bit too much on that. There's Haysom playing in the wing defence position for Guernsey, desperately trying to keep that ball in play. Our umpires for today's game, Amy Lebouvar and Louise Mower. Big shout out also to the technical officials who are working between the two benches, team benches, and keeping everyone in line. So great, and a big thank you. Great to see them. Big thank you to all of their volunteer work during this competition. For Guernsey, get a goal on the board. Tilly Graham putting the ball back, using the work of Rose Haysom at wing defence. Just a loss of possession there gives Jersey another chance. With a 5-goal lead as we move into just 4 minutes played, as we see there the strength and the excellent take and turn to post from Leah Griffin. Graham desperately looking to feed the ball forward, but again the line of the Jersey defence, that strong wall of red we could see there as the whistle went for the Guernsey centre pass. So credit to Lampede, Larish and Chater, very strong defensive pressure. And again, Guernsey trying to get this ball through on the first phase. Ball goes back. And that's Hasten supporting on the wing defence. Strong hands there from the goal defence for Jersey, Catherine Larish. Jersey with Devine, the captain in possession, quickly transitioning through the court. Toner wants it. See that loose double defence and great pressure. Unlucky there, Guernsey. Really tracked well there. Just lost sight of the ball as it was coming in. Otherwise, that would have been a great defensive piece of work for the circle pairing. There we go. So Saunders picks off the ball. So Guernsey on the defence. Guernsey trying to split the line of red as they move through court. So important, Guernsey just try and get themselves ball side. That was great play, excellent use of the whip, and that finds Braho under the post. Contact court on Norland, so Guernsey in possession. Fortunate footwork there by Tilly Graham. Norman looks long into the pocket. Toner feeds Griffin. It's a 2-on-1, but that ball still gets to Griffin. Over the ball, doesn't stop the ball getting through to Saunders. Sorry, Braho offloading there to Yabsley. Space there from Norman, plays in Toner, just not able to convert. As Guernsey transition forwards again, Norman, Graham looks long. Lampede disrupting play once again. Excellent defender, goes hunting for the ball, and a very tight one-on-one defensive player. So Lampede rewarded as Griffin puts that ball into the net. Great start from Jersey, 11 goals to Guernsey's 3. Lots of communication at the back, the goalkeeper for Jersey, as we see there, some pressure coming through. Graham puts that ball to Yabsley, and a super goal by Yabsley. So Griffin scores again, using the midcourt as well around the circle edge. Guernsey just need to be aware of the midcourt and how they support Griffin. Try and force them, if they can, away from the side that Griffin holds. Breho. Great shooting by Breho. Another ball and goal onto the scoreboard for Jersey. So Breho elects to get on the move, moving the defensive pair from Jersey. That's a great pickup there from Larice as Jersey fast on the transition through the midcourt. Norman double play with Tona. And again into the hands of Griffin. Just protecting the pocket that they want that ball to go to. Just not enough space there. So, Akaka, captain for Guernsey today, supporting through court. And swings the ball. Breho with the shot secures another goal. Great start from Donna Breho. Great switch of lead there as Tona finds herself under the post. Excellent, well-placed ball coming through to Tona. Yabsley. Another mid-range shot for Yabsley. Hold on to that one as Guernsey power on forwards, McCracken supporting. Graham looks long, finds Yabsley. So both shooters working their way back into the circle. Larice Devine too strong on that occasion for Breho and Yabsley, and a fast transition. Tona under the post. So Jersey moving out to a healthy scoreline against their local rivals, and it's a 15-7 game at the moment. Guernsey still continue to work hard, just a loss of possession there. Ball a little bit low for Yabsley. Tony again supported well on the edge of the circle. Chater and Norman. So Norman taking the majority of the centre pass first phase for Jersey. Guernsey might just be considering a change of defensive pressure on that first phase. Final minute of this first quarter. Excellent take there. Tilly Graham turns to post. He actually gets the penalty, so there should be a 2-on-1 in the shooting circle. Breho forced to use Graham on the edge. Unfortunate there. Excellent pickup from the goalkeeper and captain Lauren Devine for Jersey. switches the lead with Yabsley. Excellent play. Moves in along the goal line. Great goal from Braho. A mix up of the timing, just holding onto the ball a little bit longer sometimes. The Guernsey attack, and that has actually helped them commit the defence. So, final seconds. Guernsey probably forced to take this pass, needs to be quick. Not able to get the ball into the hands of Braho. So, end of the first quarter in this, the second game of day three. Jersey, 18 goals to Guernsey, 8. So, time for the coaches just to regroup, set some strategy with their players. We'll be back for the second quarter and commentary in a few minutes' time. Of the second game today, day three of the Invitational Island Games, as Jersey make a quick start through to goal. Ball in the hands of Griffin, over to Toner. So Jersey developing a lead in the first quarter, and we've got a scoreline of 18 goals to Guernsey's 8 as Griffin puts another goal on the board for Jersey. change for either side at the start of the second quarter. Rose Haysom goes off to the bench at wing defence for Guernsey, and Viv Kemney comes on to court at wing defence. And for Jersey, Larish goes off and Llewellyn comes on to goal defence. Possession and a great long ball through to Griffin. Shot from Yabsley scores for Guernsey. So a goal off the Jersey centre pass. Can Guernsey score on their own on this occasion? Great run ball side there by Norman. And Graham working hard at centre for Guernsey. Spreho. Not afraid to take the long shot, Spreho. And so far, Guernsey, when they can deliver that ball through, Spreho responds. Into play out of the circle. Braho trying to move the defensive pairing. And that's a pickup for Jersey by Antonia Chater as Blampede launches that ball through court. Just Toner not able to keep that one in play. So again, Blampede mopping up in the midcourt. Toner on the double play. And settles the Jersey attack with another goal. 23 goals Jersey, 10 Guernsey. Guernsey just need to be careful not to force that ball forwards on the option, particularly when Braho has got a double defence right with her and limited space available at the back. Goal defence, so Jersey with Norman back in possession. Yeah. shooters again in the middle. So, chance for Guernsey. No shooters in the circle at the moment. And there we go again. That's the pickup by Lauren Devine, the captain for Jersey. Super offload from Toner to Griffin. Time called as the Jersey centre Antonia Chater goes off onto the bench. Lovely, pulls herself out, works her way in. Throw-in to Jersey, ball deemed to have been out of court. Guernsey goalkeeper there, Ola Saunders, just calling an injury time. So Tony Chater goes to the bench and it's Molly Luce who replaces Chater at centre for Jersey. Griffin steadies for the shot. Just time will be held there as Graham just went down in the midcourt. Then Saunders goes off from goalkeeper and McCracken drops to goalkeeper with Haysom at goal defence. Yavsley. Guernsey 11 goals on the board against Jersey with 31, and Jersey just trying to launch the long ball there, too much on that, gives possession back to Guernsey. McCracken supports well at the back. Guernsey just forced back. It is Sophie Taylor that replaces Tilly Graham at centre for Guernsey. Yeah. play the short game. Long ball then launched by McCracken. Good solid ball there to Brejo through the top of the circle. Top of the circle feed to try and get the ball to Brejo. Picked off by the tight defence of Jersey. Defensive work there, so that's the new combination. Llewellyn with Devine for Jersey at the back. Good team defence there, and Jersey straight through the court, really fast on their transition, secure another goal. Their centre pass. Reads the ball so well, just drops slightly off the line of the ball and then creeps away in and takes possession. Solid defence from Blampied. Hemney picks up the ball, just requires that patience, that vision, just to sight the best option going forwards. Get the chance as we approach final 2 minutes in the second quarter. Hemney. And Yadsley finds. Actually trying to get the ball through to Chamberlain there, Yadsley in the pocket. Just too much on that ball as it swings across. Brejo. Again, excellent defensive pressure from Jersey. Great use of the width of the court in the middle there, and a super take from the goal defence from Guernsey. So, rewarded there, Hasten with that tracking of Toner through in the goal third. Studies, just gets the rebound. So final minute as Guernsey make their way through to goal with Blampied. And great hold. Strong position by Griffin, propped up behind the defence. The whole of the back space available for that ball to go into. So 15 seconds less. Kenny disrupts the flow of play. And the footwork call, Norman Quick to get the ball through to Griffin. But McCracken and Hasten stop that ball going in for another goal. So at the end of the second quarter, Jersey 37 goals to Guernsey 11. short break. The coaches, I'm sure, will be looking to consider potential changes. We've seen a few changes so far in this match. Join us again shortly after the half-time break, and we'll be back with commentary for the remaining half of this game. We'll be right back. come back for the third quarter as we welcome both teams back onto court. Just to take you through some changes for Guernsey as they start this third quarter with a centre pass. Cottrell goes to wing attack, Greening to goal attack, Haysom goes to goalkeeper, Kemney goal defence, Pinchmain wing defence, Taylor to centre, and Yabsley drops to goal shooter. Changes for Jersey, so Blampy, Chater, Devine off to the bench, Dos Santos wing defence, Fitzgerald Wilkins goal attack, Goddard centre, Larish goalkeeper, and Luce wing attack. Rosie Toner drops in at goal shooter. Jersey are citing their main game up against the Isle of Man, and I'm sure we will see a great contest between these two sides. So Guernsey trying to work through the defensive pressure of Jersey. Now for Guernsey is Abby Greening and Vicky Yabsley. Able to secure the goal as they go again on their centre pass. Toner moves out at shooter, plays herself through to post. To take those mid and long range shots, equally can work herself to the post as well. So showing some good court craft. The mid quarters from Guernsey just need to be careful of the long rangy arms of Georgina, Ruellen and Evelyn Larish playing in defence. Side in this game, different combinations onto court. Leah Griffin gave an excellent account of herself at goal shooter, as we've witnessed throughout all of the Jersey games so far. Different combinations on court now for Jersey, same strategies being applied. So squad members just fitting in, knowing their duty, knowing their role in each of the positions. Well done, Abby Greening, manages to put another goal onto the board for Guernsey. Transition by Jersey, the team in red, as you see, moving down to goal to the right of the screen. Tona uses the out and in support from the mid-quarters on the edge of the circle really well. Great take from Kemney. Tona just pulls out, takes a defender with her, and there we see Fitzgerald Wilkins make her way through to post and score. So Jersey 48 goals, Guernsey 14, as we get close to the halfway mark in quarter three. Super shot there from Abby Greening. Clinical centre pass follows from Jersey. So all players just on the ball side there. Ball taking that direct route to goal, limiting any opportunity for the defence to come into play. For Jersey, finds Tona. And a contact call there. Tona keeps the ball in play and advantage played by the umpire. So Jersey, the all-important 50 goals for them. Forced back Jersey, not afraid to reset, go again. And that's Goddard on the top of the circle. Tona gets the shot. Good rebound. Fitzgerald Wilkins scores the goal. A one-on-one situation in the circle there with Tona up against the work of McCracken. And it's Haysom that we see at goalkeeper now for Guernsey. So some versatility in and around the Guernsey squad. Haysom played wing defence, now at goalkeeper. Henley arms over the ball, just called for the obstruction. Back to the transverse line as we see Cotterill at wing attack with possession. So, chance for Guernsey. Unfortunate, an offside call there. Gets the penalty, collects the rebound, and again. So good work, Jersey. Another goal, 54 goals to Guernsey 15. Kona holding the front position against Kemeny. The same little pop there from Fitzgerald Wilkins. Kona again, keeping the one-on-one there, so Fitzgerald Wilkins keeps out of the circle, delays that move in, and the one-on-one, Kona up against Hayson, working for Jersey, as Kona pops another one over to Fitzgerald Wilkins. Of the ball carrier when Guernsey move through with possession in their goal third. Jersey fast to transition. A real mix-up of style of play through the court. Always using the width through the mid-court area, which does actually give them a great opportunity for different options as they enter the goal third. Keeper, that's Rose Hayson that we've talked about, moved from wing defence into goalkeeper for Guernsey. Shooter for Guernsey and Vicky Yabsley now on the bench. Zola Saunders for Guernsey, another player that can play at both ends of the court, goal shooter and at goalkeeper. seconds then on the clock. Guernsey aware of the time. Jersey come in and steal possession. So Norman, Toner, Fitzgerald Wilkins plays a little bit nearer to the post, manages to secure another goal as we get into final seconds. The centre pass won't be taken. That's a scoreline of 60 goals to Jersey, 16 to Guernsey. The all-important final quarter remaining. It's been a fantastic performance by Jersey. An excellent scoreline opened up for them. Join us back in a few minutes' time for that final 15 minutes of this, the second game on day three. Of this, the second game on day three. It's Jersey up against their local rivals, Guernsey. And what a healthy scoreline Jersey have. It's 62 goals to 16 as Guernsey starts us off in this final 15 minutes. So for Guernsey, Zola Saunders, we saw come back on at goal shooter, but now Brejo returns to that position. So Brejo back in the shooter position where she started this game. And thought that has just given her an opportunity to take a look, maybe rest some legs, and she's back in action. Changes for Jersey. Chater comes to centre. Dos Santos, goal defence. Goddard, wing defence. And we see Larish and Ruellen go to the bench. Sorry, Ruellen, goalkeeper. Being tried and tested, players being rotated just to help performances throughout this five-day competition. Jersey playing their third game today, having played Shetland yesterday and Orkney the day before. So looks like Jersey will be tallying 3 wins on the board after this game today, firmly with their sights on having a good crack against world-ranked Ireland, the Isle of Man, as they get towards the end of the week. As we see there again, the work of Fitzgerald Wilkins linking nicely with Toner in the shooting circle. Available to Toner as that ball just forces its way out of court. So Hasten and Henry in there to try and stop Jersey putting any more goals in, but that's Fitzgerald Wilkins. Possession with Jersey. Goddard and Dos Santos supporting well as defence coming through the midcourt for Jersey. Just gives Toner an opportunity with Fitzgerald Wilkins to drop back. Takes a bit of pressure off when the two defenders support through that midcourt area. Greening just hovering around the edge of the circle there. Dos Santos tries to come round. He's caught on the penalty. Greho secures another goal on the board for Guernsey. Menzies Centre just rolling a feet into the shooting circle. So an offside call as Toner picks up that long ball under the post and scores again for Jersey. So under 9 minutes remaining in this fourth quarter of the second game on day three. Later this evening, it will be the home nation, the Isle of Man, playing Shetland. So that game will commence at 6 p.m. For Jersey, then they'll get to rest only until tomorrow morning at 10, when they will be up against Innismar. Guernsey will play at 2 o'clock tomorrow and they will play Shetland. Toner just holds at the top of the circle, giving opportunity to time the move, moving towards goal when that ball's placed nicely between Toner and the post. So again, Jersey, turn of possession at the centre pass. So Guernsey back on the defence. Fitzgerald Wilkins. The defence from Guernsey just getting caught behind on the two Jersey shooters at the moment, so a little bit more maybe offline defence, just pulling their feet and their body away slightly, not allowing the shooters to prop up against them and hold those positions, particularly the front. So a mix of strategy would help Guernsey in defence. Greening, chance to score. And again, another good mid-range shot from Greening. Great take by Hasten, looks long. Swings the ball, tries to get the ball to a mid-quarter to feed into Greening, but gets it back and scores. Good playmaker, Brejo really does work hard to try and get players into the right position and move the ball safely to that shooting opportunity. Tries to come forward, supports through the middle. Good defence in the mid-channel by Jersey. Greening. Replay gives Jersey possession into the final 5 minutes of the fourth quarter. A great scoreline for Jersey. Some solid learnings from Guernsey as they switch the combinations, continue in their progress and development. So lots of positives for both sides to take from this game. Jersey the most clinical in terms of structure and some excellent shooting percentages from Leah Griffin and Toner. Not forgetting the interchanges of Madison Fitzgerald Wilkins as well, the goal attack for jersey. If she can play an out and in, play the ball out and just transition to get closer to the post, that might be helpful, just to help certainly the attacking end from Guernsey. Kenny just almost gets that arm over, just caught in the distance. So great arms over Kenny, just needs to get the distance first. Gets herself ball side. Good shooter to shoot the ball there, Greho to Greening. Jersey, 26 to Guernsey. Guernsey never give up the fight, get more goals onto the board. Greho, post gets in the way as she tries to get the ball through to Greening. Final minute, it would be great if Guernsey can take this through to goal, put the ball through the net, finish strong, give them the confidence for tomorrow's game. So Kemney will take the penalty, mid-court. Greho keeps the ball on the same side, gets the penalty. Excellent shot from Greho, final seconds of this game. It's been a fine account by Jersey. Serena Kirsten, I'm sure, will be looking to make more improvements. However, an impressive performance. 79 goals on the board for Jersey. Surely the last goal goes to Greho as she puts another goal in. So, great performances all round. Lots of positives to take from Guernsey. Not the winners today, Jersey back on top. Guernsey learning all the time, taking lots of new information off each match and getting ready, preparing well for the next. Jersey 79, Guernsey 28 at the end of this. The second game on day three, as we see all the players just shaking hands and... big thank you to our umpires for that game, the technical officials. The results you can see on the screen, and also our next game, 6 p.m. it's scheduled for. It's the Isle of Man versus Shetland. So lots of netball to look forward to as we pretty much get to the halfway point of this, the inaugural Invitational Island Games. So Serena Kirsten just with her squad there, and Bridget Yabsley too. Lots of information, lots of encouragement, I'm sure, from both coaches. So I'll be leaving you in commentary and handing over now to courtside for those all-important, interesting interviews coming your way in a few minutes' time.
Experience an island like no other. The Isle of Man, the extraordinary story. Book now.
Well, welcome to the Isle of Man and a very special event, the first of the Invitational Island Netball matches.
Playing against teams of this standard is something we don't get to do very often, being from an island community. And even watching some of the matches that's going to be coming up this week is going to be an amazing experience.
It's the first time that we've been involved in anything of the scale as well. Just the exposure for all our players is really good.
We've got 15 players with us, and we have youth and experience. We're hoping to use everybody throughout the week.
We've had a look at some of the teams. We know the Isle of Man are 27th in the ranking at the moment, so know that they're going to be quite a tough team. Jersey and Guernsey have been a setter for quite a while now, and Orkney and Shetland as well are teams that we're looking to compete against.
Everyone says it's all fun and games, but you kind of want it to be serious. You want to go out with a few wins.
We're really lucky that we've got a really strong mix of players, that their combinations can be moved all around.
And for 5 days with netball, it's a lot to ask from them.
Absolutely. We know that those all 12 of the girls that are over with us are going to have to work their socks off. And for us, it's the first time we've done anything like this.
We know it's tournament netball and anything can happen. I'm going to have to earn every moment out there. But yeah, we'll be going for it for this week. We want to go out on top. Everyone has usually played everyone at some point and seen everyone at some point. That hasn't happened this time round. So there is a lot of unknown.
There's a much bigger picture at play here, and it's about not just representing your island, but representing netball at this competition and in the Island Games. And I think going forward, that's something that we all share, a common goal.
It's a great feeling playing for Orkney, and we've not really done anything outside of Scotland. And all we really have is our inter-county match against Shetland every year and the Scottish Cup that we enter.
I think for us, it's just seeing what we've done. Have we prepared in the way that we should prepare?
Yep.
Or do we need to go back and reflect and see where we need to go for there?
We've hosted a few competitions like this now, but the nerves are still there and we still want to do well for a home crowd. So although we're experienced, we still get the same adrenaline. And that's what this makes this competition quite exciting. It's nice to play new opponents, and it's nice to play people that haven't played us before. So we're really looking forward to it. This has been all over social media. There's been a lot of excitement around it, and I think netball fans on the island are looking forward to this as well.
Probably just like to take a moment just to thank the Isle of Man Netball really for taking a leap of faith and backing the teams, backing the game, and getting ourselves in a position where we can run something like this.
Final score then in the Channel Island Derby between Guernsey and Jersey. Jersey have come out comprehensive winners, 79 points to 28. And I've got Kat Larish with me from Jersey. That's a pretty good performance, and top scorers of the competition so far with that 79
Oh yeah, we're really, really pleased. I mean, the most important thing for us is to try and always stick to principles. And, you know, Serena's like, make sure we're still doing all the things that we've been learning all season and we've been training for and working really hard for all through defence and attack, and just keep doing it and keep playing our game as much as we can.
Well, you got off to a great start. Leah be happy getting her first shoot in the goal today as well.
Yes.
But was linking up really well with Rosie at that start, and nothing really changed after that when Maddie come on and Rosie went to goal shooter. You continued that. Maddie may not be the tallest, but she's great to find space.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, Maddie was a little bit disappointed with her performance yesterday, so it was really amazing to see her come on today and really, you know, play so brilliantly and show such an excellent performance. Her shooting was amazing, and like you said, she's so good at finding that little gap and breaking through and getting to goal as well. And then she'll be really pleased with that, and we are also proud of her performance and everyone's performance today.
Yeah, well, of course, defensively as well, you know, we must give them a mention. Obviously, you're in the defence too, but great. Got a lot of the rebounds that you took advantage of, and some great link-ups from the back with Jodie as well.
Yeah, absolutely. So all of us took to court today, which was brilliant, and all of us in defence as well. I mean, Georgie, she came down 2 days ago, and she had quite a bad ankle injury, so she's been rehabbing that and managed to take to court today, which is fantastic, and you know, play brilliantly and show an excellent performance. So it was really nice to have her play, and Layla, she's only 16 and she managed to get in and play in defence, and me and Lauren as well, and Jodie as well at the start in wing defence, making some key interceptions and all working as a unit together to make sure that we were turning the ball and working really hard as a team.
Have you stuck to the game plan that Serena's put together at the very start?
Yeah, absolutely. We're trying to stick to it as much as possible. And like Serena said, she always just wants us to play our game, regardless of the score, regardless of what's going on court, regardless of, you know, how we're feeling. We still stick to game plan, and we still keep ploughing through, regardless of everything else. Yeah. And just keep each other's confidence up, keep supporting one another, and, you know, just keep the communication up together.
Yeah. And Serena's got that lovely, she's got that great experience, obviously, but that lovely calm and nature about it as well. She's not shouting and yelling at anyone, not yet anyway.
No, absolutely. I mean, I think that we all shout way more on the bench than Serena does. But Serena's just really, you know, laser focused. And like you said, she's so calming, and it's amazing to have her as our coach. And she just, you know, little tidbits of key information. And that's all we need, because, you know, like she says, we've done all the hard work. We know what we need to do. We just need to go out there and do it.
Well, brilliant performance today. Well done.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
There we go. Kat Larish there from Jersey. And let's get a word with Abby McCracken from Guernsey. Well, to say that was a tough game, Abby, it was a tough game.
It was a really tough game, but we knew what we were coming up to. So I thought the girls played really well, and we worked as a unit, so lots to learn from, but we did really well today, and we beat our interinsular score from March, so we're really happy.
Well, that's the way forward, though, isn't it? Looking to get the positives out of it and instead of the negatives, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. We knew it was going to be a tough game, so we had our individual targets, and we worked to those today, so we're happy.
Yeah, and I suppose a bit of a loss for you in the middle there when Tilly went off. I hope she's not injured too bad.
I know. I hope she's going to be okay. I don't know what we're going to do without her.
She's a workhorse, isn't she?
She definitely is. She is awesome.
But Abby Greening there, you know, got a lot of the goals in, and some great long shots as well and goals.
Abby loves a long shot. She's brilliant. She's worked really hard today and just worked really well.
But everyone growing in confidence with their own game, regardless of the results?
Yeah, absolutely. This is the first time Guernsey are playing together, so we're still working out how everyone works. But yes, everyone's doing better at each game.
Did you get a chance back in Guernsey to many members of this squad that play together in the local sides?
So there are a couple of girls that play together, but it's all a mix of clubs.
What about playing on this sort of court? Does that make a difference for you?
Definitely.
It seems grippy.
It's really nice, yeah. Hopefully we can get some in Guernsey, but yeah, we're not used to this kind of style at all.
Yeah, in action again tomorrow?
In action again tomorrow, yeah. Looking forward to it.
Great. Well, that's what we like to hear. Looking forward to all the games,
yeah,
regardless, and ever improving in your own games, and that's the important thing.
Absolutely.
Well done, anyway.
Thank you.
There we are. That was Abby McCracken from the Guernsey squad there, putting up a great speech for a team there at the end of a pretty hefty defeat in that game against Jersey. Next match on this evening is the Isle of Man, who are in action against Shetland, and that gets away at 6 o'clock this evening, where the support, I suppose, will be growing in the arena here at the National Sports Centre. They'll be warming up from 5, and we'll have live streaming and live commentary for the match just before 6 o'clock.